Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. In preparation for its first spaceflight test next month, NASA's Orion spacecraft was transported from Kennedy Space Center's Launch Abort System facility to Space Launch Complex 37 at nearby Cape Canaveral Air Force Station on November 11, arriving at the pad early November 12. NASA's new deep space exploration capsule then was attached to the top of the Delta IV Heavy rocket that will carry it to space for the December 4th test. Just hours after leaving the International Space Station on November 9th, the Expedition 41 crew safely touched down in Kazakhstan at 10:58 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. NASA's Reid Wiseman, Russian cosmonaut Max Sergeyev, and Alexander Gerst of the European Space Agency completed a 165-day mission. Meanwhile, the Expedition 42-43 crew, including NASA's Terry Virts, traveled from Star City, Russia to Kazakhstan to complete training for their scheduled launch to the station later this month. During a November 10th meeting in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden discussed continued Earth science research collaboration with leaders of the Regional Center for Mapping of Resources for Development. The Intergovernmental Organization of African States is host to a joint NASA and USAID venture that provides developing nations with satellite-based Earth observation data and science applications to help improve environmental and natural resource decision-making. After sailing through space for more than a decade, the European Space Agency's Rosetta spacecraft successfully landed its Philae robotic probe on the surface of Comet 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko on November 12, completing the first ever soft landing of a spacecraft on a comet. NASA has three instruments on the orbiting Rosetta spacecraft, which will spend about 18 months studying the comet. Team members of NASA's Asteroid Redirect mission, including program manager Michelle Gates, recently visited Goddard Space Flight Center to check out simulated mission scenarios and prototype technologies that could be used to retrieve a boulder off of a larger asteroid, one of the two asteroid capture concepts NASA will choose between by late 2014. The other would fully enclose an asteroid using an inflatable system. The Asteroid Redirect mission will advance the technologies and experience needed to send humans to Mars in the 2030s. A panel discussion on November 12th at the Intrepid Sea, Air, and Space Museum in New York City featured crew members of Space Shuttle Mission STS-125, the last servicing mission to NASA's Hubble Space Telescope. April 24th of next year marks the 25th anniversary of Hubble's launch on STS-31, featuring current NASA Administrator and then astronaut Charlie Bolden as the pilot of Space Shuttle Discovery's crew. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.